Hi guys, welcome to BNG TV. I'm Basola Shapoji, and today we are here with Official Solo. Is that how you say
it? That's how you say it.
Okay, so if I'm being so real, you're firming it, you're waiting for it. If I'm being so real, I did not know who you were, like, until they told me this is who's coming in. Like, and they were saying, oh, he done a feature with Tion Wayne. So is that recently?
Yeah, that's recent. It just came out literally, what, 4 days ago?
Were you doing music before that?
Yeah, I've got a couple other tracks out there. I've got a track with, have you heard of Gekko?
Yeah,
Jekka Joe, and it's called Jekka Joe. Got another track with Ade Josh and Sachi, called Grand and Flex as well. I've got a few out there, obviously.
So how, in terms of people, because I generally didn't know who you were. Like,
yeah, that's understandable.
Like, so it's like, are you saying that with Tion Wayne, you had to get with Tion Wayne to you know, to get up there, car. I fully, is that out?
It's out now, but that's not how it went. Basically, obviously, my manager, he actually knows Tion Wayne popular, like, you know what I'm saying? Obviously, we're together, and then I played him the track, and he's like, yeah, I like it. And I was like, okay, why not, you understand?
So wait, what would you do? Sorry, you sing?
Yeah, I sing.
And rap?
I just sing.
What, so how do you learn? Do you reckon you can sing?
I'm not no Trey Song, but I'm just there. I'm not a singer, I'm just there.
So you're a singer, you're not an Afrobeat artist, you're a singer.
I'm an Afrobeat artist, but I can sing as well, that makes sense.
So what, would
but
you compare yourself artist. To Malogo?
I don't know, man.
Because Malogo can sing.
Malogo can sing as well, yeah, he's good, man, but yeah, man, I'm an Afrobeat artist.
So too, how are you going to raise this publicity thing? Because no one knows.
Yeah, because you know the problem right now is obviously as well, the fact that if you're from like North Manchester, then that's where I'm based in it. So a lot of people in Manchester know.
Okay, so Manchester not know.
Yeah, Manchester.
You. Yeah, you need to bring that down here.
Yeah, 100%. Then, we're working on that. It's just started.
Okay, all right then. All right, so, you know, I did have to do research anyway. So you know that Jekka Joe song that you're just talking about? I did watch that.
Yeah.
And you were talking Yoruba, like, you were singing in Yoruba.
Yeah.
Like, and people who do that, you know, these girls, these Nigerian girls, they love that. So, were you born there? Were you born in Nigeria?
I was actually born here, but I went over to Nige.
Oh, you got shipped.
I got shipped. I can't believe I got shipped.
At least you're owning it, man. I was going to get shipped.
Yeah. So obviously, I stayed there for like 3 years. I went to school there, so that's when I kind of picked up a lot more.
Okay.
I got my stuff and everything. Then, yeah.
All right. So speak Yoruba now.
Just what you would say.
Nah, say anything that comes to your mind.
Like what?
Say anything. We're waiting.
Solo no more.
What's that?
That means solo.
That's not
kid.
Even. That's that not is, a sentence.
It
that's,
is, but it's, you said anything. You
no,
said anything.
Okay. Like, no, a sentence. Say a sentence. So girls can you know melt.
All right. Cool. Who call me Solim? Basically, that means my name is Solim, you know what I mean?
Yeah, well, yeah.
But don't get, I'm not 100% perfect though, because don't forget, I literally went there for 3 years, you get me?
But so 3 years, perfect. You can learn a lot in 3 years.
Yeah, 100%, I did. Like, before I went there, I couldn't speak nothing, like, I couldn't understand nothing.
Okay.
So when I went there, I learned a lot of things, 100% sure.
So, where do you see this music thing going? Like, do you consider yourself as, like, proper talented to be able to do it, like, in a long run, or...
Yeah.
Are you going to get a degree or what?
To be fair with you, I can't lie, I think we're going kind of fast because we only started this, like, when I say we, I mean my team, innit? We only started
Who's
this,
your
like,
team? Who's your team?
I've got a couple managers and a couple cameramen, this and that. So, obviously some of us are based in
London. You seem like you're shaking.
No, I'm alright, man. Don't put me on the spot.
Calm down, you seem like, you know,
don't
you're like...
Don't put me on the spot.
It's alright, man.
But like I was saying now, yeah, it's like, basically, we just started, like, not a year. So... And it's not been up to a year yet, and we're making kind of big movements, we're making some kind of noise now and again, do you understand? And obviously, we've also got, I don't know, like you said, I do feel like I do have the potential to actually make it into an actual proper
that's
profession.
At least so, you feel like that.
Yeah, 100%, man.
And that's all you need to do that. Like, so what I want you to do, I'm going to put you on a proper spot. Sing, you see how in... Yeah, you need to sing something. You see how you
can You know what, yeah? I can't lie to you.
You're going
to
sing.
I can't lie to you.
You're going to sing.
I'll be with you. On my life, I would actually sing. But because of the fact that I've just had some mess, tons of stuff, I can't.
That means you can't sing.
I can't sing
in general. Because a singer will be able to sing anywhere.
If you, I don't know, man. Like I said, I'm not no Trey Songz. I'm not really a singer like that. Do you understand?
Sing.
I'm not really a singer like that. So it's a bit weird, man.
Sing a bit weird. Now.
But I can't lie to you. I would actually sing another time. Catch me again. I'm going to be here another time.
Just
and I would sing.
You
understand?
You can't sing.
100% I can sing.
You can't sing. That's right. But that's okay.
But check out YouTube,
not
check out SoundCloud.
Can sing.
I've got some live sessions as well on YouTube and SoundCloud. So check me out.
But this is live. You can sing now.
Yeah, but I literally just have some mad operation. Like my cousin's there. Everyone's there.
Operation on what?
Cousin's there. So it's like on my life, I know I could sing, but I don't wanna, you understand? So it's one of them ones, but
No. Okay, you know,
man.
I want to play a game, yeah?
Yeah, go on.
This is another putting you on the spot because you have to think now, and I need you to be quick because people don't have time to waste.
Yeah, of course.
So we're going to play two truths and one lie.
Okay.
Do you know that game?
No, but you can teach me through
Okay, so basically, I'm going to say three things about myself.
Yeah.
And two of them are like, they're proper true, and one's a lie, and you have to figure out which one. And you have to do that as well. So as I'm doing it, you need to think of what you're going to say, okay?
Cool.
All right, so my ones, yeah.
Yeah.
I've been pregnant before.
Yeah.
I've been banged in the face before.
Yeah.
And I'm an only child. Which one's the lie?
Are they all true? It can't all be true, can it?
No, one's a lie. Which one's the lie?
I don't know. I'll go for the only child one. Only because of the fact that.
So you're trying to tell me I've been pregnant before. So what do I look like?
No. Only because of the fact that for someone to actually say they've been pregnant before, it's like, I don't know, man. Only because of the fact that for you to actually say it, it means that, yeah, you could have been pregnant before. There's nothing bad in that. Like, what? How old are you?
I'm 19.
Yeah, it's not bad that my common people get pregnant at 15, 16
nowadays. That's the lie. That's the maddest thing. So you're basically trying to say that I look like that kind of person.
No, I'm not even.
You're horrible.
There's no such thing as look like that kind of person.
Okay, but you can't sing, but that's okay. I'm not saying that. I'm not trying to, you know, but okay, your turn. Hey. See, what are you thinking?
I'm thinking shit.
Alright, go on.
Let me play it safe, yeah? I've got a girl pregnant before. Yeah. I'm the only child. And I'm trying to think of another one. I support Liverpool.
Okay, that one kind of took you long to think about. It's like that's the lie.
No, that's actually true. I support Liverpool. Yeah, I actually do support Liverpool.
So okay, what was your third one?
What was my third one again? Basically, yeah, I've got a girl pregnant before.
Yeah.
I support Liverpool.
Yeah, and
what was my third one again?
Your only child?
Yeah, I'm not the only child, so I'm not the only child, innit?
No, you see, you're lying.
I was saying, wait, hold on, what did I say again?
You're stupid.
That's not the only child?
Yeah, you said you're the only child.
Oh, cool.
So that's the lie.
So, okay, yeah, cool, that's the lie, basically.
So you've got someone pregnant before?
Next question, baby. If you come into my interviews, now I have to ask.
So what, do you have a kid?
I actually don't have a kid, innit, so, but yeah, like I said, innit, I'm gonna be honest.
We're gonna have some soft music, man. It's a sad now. Oh, you're a bad shoot. Oh,
it happens, man.
At least your supporters know that, man. I'm sorry, it had to come out.
I'll be real, man.
Damn, man. I'm not gonna ask you stuff about that. Let's change that. You're Nigerian.
Yeah.
Nigerian or Ghanaian jollof rice?
Come on, man. You can't even ask that kind of question.
No, but I'm Nigerian and I think Ghanaian jollof rice. So.
I don't know, man. But then you're a sellout.
I'm not a sellout.
You're a sellout. You can't ask that question. That's like saying, I don't know, man. Nike or Gucci. You can't really say that. Like.
But I'll choose Nike.
Oh, Gucci.
Yeah. Because I'm not image like you. I'm not image.
Then again, you're not really majority as well. Do you get me? So when we say majority, like, come
so
on,
you
man,
say everyone, Nigerian.
I see. I didn't even say that. You just that means
no, but,
that
no,
means that obviously
already,
means that obviously means you know Nigerian is better. So I didn't even say
yeah.
it.
Okay.
But
yeah.
Yeah, man, I would say Nigerian, man. Because you and I both know it's better.
No, I like Ghanaian jollof rice.
Don't get to that. I do like Ghanaian jollof rice.
So what are you trying to say about Ghanaian?
No, don't get to my Ghanaian people out there. I do like Ghanaian. I'm not anti Ghanaian.
Like Ghanaian people.
I'm far above. If you know me, you know most of my past.
No one's gonna listen
really
to your
Ghanaian,
music. And you couldn't sing anyway, so now no one's gonna listen to your music even more.
Yeah, like I'm saying, I do like Ghanaian jollof rice, but I just feel Nigerian's better, you get me?
Because you're just biased, but
not really.
Anyways, this is what everyone wants to know, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Girl, I'm not gonna go into that, yeah. But is there a girl behind you supporting you? A girl or someone you're talking to, you know, don't shame yourself,
yeah, yeah,
innit?
I don't want you to have
to write paragraphs after
yeah,
this,
yeah,
innit?
Explaining. So, basically, a girl that's supporting me
or a girlfriend or someone you're talking to, you know how we all go through
that talking to stage.
Like, is there someone?
So, it can just be a girl, yeah?
Well, someone important. Is there a girl? So, like,
my sister, of course. My sister, she's always talking to me, always supporting me, man.
But
so,
you know what I'm talking about? Okay, so are you trying to say, hey, name you over gold, yeah? What are you trying to say, your sister's that girl?
No, but you just said somebody.
You don't
want to
put yourself out
said,
like that, nigga, you know?
You just clearly said, yeah, someone, a girl that's talking to
you. You know what I mean, though,
a
girlfriend.
I've got a sister.
Or,
that's Papa supporting me, and Papa I talk to as well, you understand? That, but when
that's
you,
disgusting.
But if you're mean the other way.
You see how you're putting it, that's nasty. You just, that's but, disgusting. Listen, a girlfriend, do you have a girlfriend?
A girlfriend, no, I don't have a girlfriend. Not yet. I'm still
not yet?
No,
I'm still talking to someone?
No, not yet.
Do you think you're gonna have a girlfriend this year?
No rush in it. See, I'm still young in it, so we'll see how it goes, man. No rush, man. No rush.
Hey, you think cool?
No rush. I'm too young for all of that, man. I'm too young for all of that, man. No, none of
you're
that,
too
man.
Young for a girlfriend. Yeah, people are getting married at what, 21?
Yeah, people are getting pregnant at 19. So, see what I mean?
Yeah, you know about that, innit? You would know about that. You know what else? Let's just change the script again. Obviously, I had to do my research on you because I did not know who you were.
Yeah.
So, I saw that you write songs. You're a songwriter. You know what? Since I was young, I've always thought songwriting is a proper talent. Like,
yeah, 100%.
So how do you do that? Like, where does your inspiration come from? Like, are you sitting in the toilet, or you have lyrics, or do you have to be in the studio to have?
You know what? The funny thing is, like, it's kind of like what you said. I could just I could be driving, and something just comes to my head, and just literally I'll record it or I'll write it down. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I come to the studio as well, and so I'll play a beat to me, but I'll get nothing. Like, it's when it comes.
So who have you wrote songs for?
I'm not going to be any artist out, but there's a couple of artists that know what I've wrote songs
for.
No,
that just shows you haven't wrote songs
for. No, because I'm not going to be an artist.
Because people would have just
I stick behind the scenes, you understand? As a songwriter, I stick behind the scenes, so I'm not going to be
out right
now.
No, but that's some rubbish.
But obviously, all my songs that I've got out there, it's all me. So, I've written myself.
Who inspires you? Like, do you have someone who inspires you? Don't say your sister, because that's already disgusting.
I've got my sister, man.
Oh, okay.
But what you say is, UK, US, Nigel?
Anyone.
I think I'll go with Nigel, and I think it's going to have to be Burna Boy, innit? Even though I'm not nothing like Burna Boy.
Burna Boy hasn't done anything over the last year.
Nah, but I don't know, you can say that, but then again, I think he has. I think he's done quite a lot. But let me go off UK. The reason I'll say UK, I think Sonna, car.
Yeah.
I think Sonna, he made a track that's fully Yoba, and it actually banged, and I kind of hate that.
Yeah, is that what you're trying to copy?
I'm not trying to copy at all, but it just shows me that anything's possible. Do you get me?
Yeah,
I can't lie, I do look up to Sonna.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
5 years?
Still singing? Hopefully you'll have a child, because that story's sad.
You're cheeky, though.
That story's sad. Hopefully you'll have a little baby, because we can't be doing that again.
But in 5 years' time, hopefully, God willing, if I am still singing, then I'm still singing. If not, then...
Are you trying to build your name, become...
Yeah, 100%. My main goal right now for these past... When I first started this, I said to myself, what I want to do in the next 2-3 years, just to let everyone know me.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not thinking about no label,
so
nothing like that.
So you went
right
with Tion Wayne, so everyone can know you. Because that's basically how I see it.
Nothing like that, man. But yeah, so I'm not trying to think about any kind of label. So if it comes, but right now I'm trying to get my name out there and let everyone know that, yeah, listen, that's all
I'm
from Manchester.
So what's your next big thing that you're about to do? Like, what should we look out for?
I'm going Morocco to shoot a new video, and also I'm going to Nigeria.
You love Nigeria, innit?
That wasn't really my consent. You know what I mean? I got shit, you understand? But this time I'm actually going with my consent and with my team. To obviously we've got a couple of connections down there. I'm gonna do some music down there and just try and push myself in Nigeria as well, you get me? So
In terms of let's go back to this girlfriend, because that's what everyone's interested in. Honestly, like, you can talk about business all you want, but people will rewind to hear all of this girlfriend juicy stuff. Yeah. So how many girlfriends have you had?
How many girlfriends I had
in your life? In
my life.
Proper ones.
Yeah. You can't wear them secondary school things.
Yeah.
I've had, let me say, 4 proper ones. That I'll say, yeah, proper.
That's a lot. So what, you didn't see marriage in them, like?
Didn't work out, because they're not here today, innit? So I guess it didn't work out.
So how do you see how you're on the come up? You say you're about to, you know, become big. So in terms of how you're going to deal with people trying to get at you, old people trying to come back, be in your life, how are you going to deal with that? Or are you still going to stay humble or have that no new friends mindset?
Really, truly, I can't lie, it's kind of happening already. Obviously, it's going to happen as well, regardless
happening
of what...
Happening how? I'm not even trying to
but
be
you know
mean,
what, you shall
but...
be with you, shall be with you. Regardless of what you're doing, as long as you're doing something right, you don't even have to be big. If you're doing something right, people want to attach to you, as long as you're not doing nothing in your life.
Preach,
so even if you've got set, like...
Let them know.
If you've got set...
Yeah.
If you're doing something that's got, I don't know, got one view, and no one's seen it, but at the end of the day, if you're doing something rap, people are gonna get onto you. So it's happening already, do you get what I'm saying? But it's one of them ones, I'm the type of person, if I've known you and you knew how I was before, then I'm gonna stick the same, I can't change. But if I feel like you weren't really believing in me, Mm-hmm. Before then, you felt, okay, cool, someone's gonna come up now, let me try and jump on his wagon, then I'm gonna be a bit, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
That's how I am, but.
Yeah,
man.
Okay, in terms of your team, who are you trying to shout out? Who's your, like, in your team? How should we, what should we look for? I know I've asked what we should look forward to and stuff, but your team, is there anyone else doing what you're doing? You know how there's like IRA movement, there's NHD?
Yeah.
Like, is it just you on your
own? It's me and my, one of my other brothers called Zone, call us a Solem and Zone. He's not here today. Solem and Zone.
Zone.
Yeah, but he's more on the R&B kind of side, you understand? So I got to shout out my boy Zone as well. And then obviously I got to shout out my, Adel G, he's like...
No, I didn't tell you to shout out. You don't have to...
You just told me to shout out.
I said, who should we look out? Who else is doing?
Yeah, look out for Adel. Because I can't lie to you, he's why I got to shout out Adel as well, because that video...
Adel Josh?
No, Adel G, innit?
Worked with Adel Josh, dude.
Yeah, I worked with Adel Josh. Big up my boy Adel Josh as well, come on. But yeah, the reason why I got shout out Adel G, because even that video was like...
What video are you talking about?
The one that you think that, yeah, I just need to make a couple.
I don't even listen to all of that. I just listen to like... 30 seconds, but
but like I'm saying, see that video, if you go back and watch that video right now, Solem featuring Tell Me, go check it out. It's like that video was a big myth, like really big myth. But
because
obviously when we went to Westfields, they were not having it for us to
record. You have to get a permit.
Yeah, they
weren't
having
that.
It, but obviously OG made it happen. And then even with the studio timing and that, just a lot of things were just I thought it was gonna be a myth, but it literally made it happen. And then when it came out, it took time, but it came out perfect. Perfect, so I've got to shout out my mate, did his miracle still.
Okay.
If you know Adi, you know he's a bit of a long guy, but what he does is magic.
You talk a lot, you know. Because I'm trying to ask questions, I can't even ask questions.
All right, go on, bro.
Are you Yoruba or Igbo?
Yoruba.
I thought you were Igbo, you know.
You just said I was speaking Yoruba.
No,
not
but
tracks.
Do you know why? Because you dress Igbo.
Why'd you say that?
You dress like one of them Igbo uncles. I swear, white, gold tooth.
I'm creasing.
Like, you're not darky. Like, you know how girls like chocolate? You're not. Do you have the other one pierced?
No, just only one. Only
like,
one.
The gold
only
tooth.
One, man,
it's very Igbo like, you know.
Nah, that's not Igbo like, man. That's just,
it is.
Know,
you look like a chief. But it could be a good thing.
So you're going to say what? You're always quite dressed nice as well, yeah? Is that what you're going to say?
What, you're about people? Are you trying to put me on the spot?
I'm just asking a question,
isn't it? I can dodge it.
Go on, dodge it then.
What do you ask?
Are you trying, what, Yoruba people, can they dress nice or not?
Yeah, they can. But you don't dress like you're Yoruba.
Okay.
That's what I'm trying to say.
Okay,
so, what now?
All right, cool.
I'm profesh, you feel me, yeah? Okay, so you mentioned that you live in Manchester. Have you been living there your whole life?
No, actually.
Where were you living before?
I used to live in Croydon, didn't I?
Okay, Croydon, when was this? What years was this? So when did you move to Manchester?
Let's say, 16 years of my life, I lived in Croydon.
Uh-huh.
So I lived in Croydon for quite a while.
How is Croydon? Hey, the Croydon I know is crazy people, annoying. I don't like. How is it different to Manchester?
I got love for Croydon,
why did you move? Are you okay to say that?
Of course. Basically, I got love for Croydon, like I said. And the reason why I actually moved is because obviously my dad's up there.
Okay.
And when I told you I went to Nige, you know, when I came out from Nige, I don't know, my mum was a bit like, I don't think you've changed. You know, I know African parents are, innit? You know what, I think you need a new environment.
Yeah,
like, I can't think about some Nige again, because no one's in Nige.
Mm-hmm.
Go, you know, go live with your dad in Manchester, have her, because she's probably thought, Manchester's just like Emmerdale setting on Coronation Street, you understand? She didn't know how Manchester was, you understand? So obviously she said, you know, go over to Manchester, let's stay with dad, and then boom, from then on.
How is Manchester like? Is it like this Emmerdale or
nah,
is
it, not? It's nothing like that at all, man.
Is it proper like London?
It's proper like London, it's proper diverse. There's a lot of talent in Manchester as well. Big up Manchester 0161, come on, man.
What's 0161?
0161, that's like, it's mad. That's basically our telephone code, isn't it? But it's everywhere in Manchester.
So,
say that. You see, like, you don't have the little 028, 0207.
Yeah,
it's like 0161, but we only got 0161. So,
everywhere?
Yeah, everywhere might hold a Manchester 0161.
Okay.
So that's literally what it is.
That's dope.
Yeah,
so,
man.
Do you run the streets of Manchester?
Nah, like, Manchester's not really like that. No one's really, it's not really
is
about
there gangs
running.
In Manchester,
of course, there's gangs everywhere. Like,
yeah,
wherever
okay,
you go,
true,
there will
true,
be gangs.
True,
you understand? There's gangs everywhere. People are doing their thing, but Manchester's not really, I think Manchester. If you're in your lane, no one will trouble you.
Okay.
You understand? So you talk
that,
a bit different,
that's
man.
That's just I'm thinking about it. It's so true. Okay, in terms of changing lifestyle, because I know even me just doing this small presenting, lifestyles change. You get more stressed. You get more anxious.
100%.
You're more busy. You have more things to do, shows, all of this. How 100%. Are you handling that? And what do you miss? Like, because with me, I feel like I miss the days where I'd just be in bed and have nothing to do. Like, literally every day I have something to do. So what do you miss and how is that for you? How's the change in lifestyle?
Yeah, I can't lie, the lifestyle's mad. The lifestyle's proper change. It's proper mad. Like, now it's like, I know I've still got a long way to go and I can't let it get to me. That's what everyone's always drilling to my head. Don't let it get to
this
you.
This is some motivation. This is motivation for you guys out there watching. Everyone who's doing their thing, it actually gets overwhelming. Trust me, it does. Like,
but don't let it get to you. Even because I've spoken to a lot of big artists, and they've told me as well, mm-hmm. like, and this is coming from big artists, they're telling me, like, yo, you know, don't let it get to you. Just keep on doing what you're doing.
You're motivating me.
It's like, with me now, how it changed and everything, because obviously now, people start to recognize me more, and more people getting onto me. I'm getting booked for shows now. Mm-hmm. I'm getting about people. Just if I'm walking around the town, center, people saying, "Oh, you're at Solis and that."
Yeah.
Like back in the days, I used to be that kind of guy. That, oh, what are you saying? What are you saying, bitch? Can I get a hug? Like, it's been a long time. But now it's like the other way around. You understand?
Yeah, so it's like,
you can't let it get to, because it's like I feel that I've not achieved nothing. Like I've still got a long way to go. And even I was speaking to Tion Wayne as well, he was telling me as well that, you know what, this is from his own mouth. He's saying that, yeah, he's got a long way to go. And I'm thinking, what? You're getting like these million views, and you're telling me you got, so I know I still got a long way to go, you understand? So there's still quite a long way
to
go.
That's a great mindset to have, because at least you're not, you're humble, basically.
You've got to stay humble, just keep on doing what you're doing. And because of the fact that the buzz is coming, don't forget it's only a buzz. It can go just the way it came.
Hey, you're preaching, not gonna lie. This is real preaching, you know.
So you got to keep on maintaining that buzz and make sure you're doing the right thing.
People are gonna like you after this year. I think people are gonna like you 100%.
Because if you just sit back on that buzz, you're not gonna mm-hmm. go nowhere. So you got to keep on maintaining. True. That's why I can't. People are getting onto me now saying, yo, man, that track, this and that, this and that. I'm in the studio. I'm trying to think of a next banger. If I don't feel that track's bigger than my other track, I'm not bringing it out. If it's not hitting the numbers, well, my Jekka Joe, it hit the song like 109k right now.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, this I'm loving, it's got to be more than 109k, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
My next track, it's got to be more than, you know what I'm saying? I've got to keep on doing better. If I'm not doing better, you understand? That's how I see us. That's why you can't let it get complacent and think, oh yeah, just because I'm getting people hitting me up now in town, this and that.
I feel like people are going to love this part of the interview, because you're proper showing yourself. This is lovely because I didn't even know you had all of this in you. Like, I just thought you talked too much, Kay. To end, I want you to say something motivational. Like, okay, describe yourself in one sentence.
One sentence.
And try and make it as motivational. But
you know, I talk a lot, innit? Like you said, I talk a lot.
Just one sentence, simple. Like, what do you do? Because people are going to watch this and they're not going to know who you are.
Yeah, but...
So, to end, who are you? What do you do in one sentence?
To end it, I'm Solem. I'm an Afrobeat artist and upcoming Afrobeat artist, based in Manchester. And we're on the come up here.
Based in Manchester? Sentence.
Yeah, based in Manchester.
Gee, that's why a lot of people don't know.
Yeah, that's really why. And based in Manchester. But don't worry, we're going to make noise though. Manchester's going to make noise. Come on, 0161.
Okay, look out for him, guys. Yeah. That's enough from us, BNG TV. Look out for our next videos. Bye.